Okay, now something really different. Something we've never done on the show before. There's been shows like The Biggest Loser, Fighting Fat, and Downsize Me.
Well, here at Tangata Pacifica, we thought we'd run our very own 12-week healthy living weight loss series. There's just one catch. The cameras are turned in on our very own reporters.
So, here's the first of Tangata Pacifica's Walk the Talk, healthy living movement.
We're about to take you on a journey. A journey that will literally take us to the edge. Nearly 64% of Pacific people in New Zealand are obese. It's a serious issue in our community. We've done lots of health stories, we've seen the stats. It's time to make a change. So we've decided to put our money where our mouth is and walk the talk. The fact is, Pacific people love food, and it shows. We're 2.5 times more likely to be obese than the rest of the New Zealand population. We are the faces of TVNZ's Pacific program, Tangata Pacifica. We're also Pacific people who love our food. Over the next few weeks, you'll see us like never before, putting ourselves and our reputations on the line for the story. Only this time, we are the story.
Well, physically, I was very sedentary. I was mostly desk-bound.
Just about every single girl in TVNZ is like half the size of me. I'm not like obese or anything. Like, you know, some of the women at church, and you know, they're like much bigger than me.
Physically, I would say in a Balangi scale, I'll be very, very obese. In a Tongan scale, I'll be very skinny.
I've just got this belt around me that's heavier and it's jiggling around.
Overweight. I was pretty relaxed on eating.
Physically, definitely morbidly obese. Big guy and definitely not healthy.
We've all been asked to take part in a 12-week series that will entail exercise and healthy eating, but not everyone was jumping at the opportunity.
First of all, I said no. I said, nah, no way.
Well, to be honest, I wasn't that keen on this idea, but I sort of rationalised it and thought, well, you know, we ask so many people in our jobs over the years to get in front of the camera for us, maybe it's my turn to bear it all.
At first I was like, yeah, that'd be cool, get fit. And then it kind of started to dawn on me that it's gonna mean I'm gonna have to start doing exercise, which I don't do exercise. But it sounds pretty full on, eh? I mean, hello. Me parking the car around work, man, it has to be within one block. I don't want to walk further than a block.
I was excited because I wanted to change the way I live, you know, especially with my parents who are unhealthy, who have diabetes. So I wanted to take this on for myself, but also, you know, it's something for the future.
We preach on our show all the time to Pacific people trying to improve their health. And so I was completely behind the fact that we should be living healthy and projecting that to the community.
And if we can show our community that we can do it and walk the talk, this is a great idea.
On reflection and talking to some of my colleagues, you know, being the biggest guy in the crew, something's wrong if I'm not doing it, you know? Everyone would be looking at all these other sort of smaller people saying, yeah, but they're not big people, you know? So, had to bite the bullet and here I am.
Eventually, the team all agreed to take part in a 12-week weight loss and healthy living series. But before any of us move a muscle, we're off to see the doctor for full medical health checks.
My name's Dr. Chang Wai.
Getting the green light from the GP before we start our training program is crucial, as we're all carrying excess weight. Some of us already harbour some serious health problems.
230. You're quite a tall person, so that's not very good.
That's not very good.
No, there might be some other problems there.
Coming up on Walk the Talk.
The rest of the team are in the obese category. If your staff were to continue this way, then in the next 5 years, there's every chance that one or two of them would have either a major heart attack or a stroke.
Oh my gosh, that doesn't sound good.
Oh, are you serious?
If they don't make the changes now, there's a higher chance of them getting into trouble.
This week we're looking at healthy living, and Tom, even though you're not officially part of the healthy living team, You've been doing some healthy living yourself, yeah?
I've been trying. I can honestly tell you it's hard. The journey is hard. So let's rejoin our crew on their walk the talk journey.
Well, to be honest, I wasn't that keen on this idea.
Overweight? It's about every single girl in TVNZ is like half the size of me.
Big guy and definitely not healthy.
There's every chance that one or two of them would have either a major heart attack or a stroke.
We've had our full health checks done and the blood results have come back to Dr. Chang Wai. This will tell us the truth about what we're putting into our bodies and what we need to do to lose weight and get healthy.
Some of it was not so surprising in terms of everybody had a high cholesterol. I think that was to be expected. There were some surprises as well.
Our youngest journalist, JP, is only 22, but has very high cholesterol for his age, and he'll need to get further tests done to determine whether or not he has diabetes.
The only thing is your sugar levels, the fasting sugar on the day was a little bit high.
When she told me my results, you know, inside my head, I was like, oh my gosh, what disease have I got this time, you know, kind of thing. My parents are both diabetic, so I know there's an increased chance. So.
Okay. Well, with that family history, then yes, you definitely need to have this one repeated.
Intrepid reporter Adrian is the lightest of the men, weighing in at 115 kilos. Although his good cholesterol is above 1, his bad cholesterol is the highest of the group at 4.7. He'll need to work on reducing his intake of fatty foods.
Bloody hell.
Your liver is still functioning okay, but if your cholesterol level stays the way it is now, then there's a good chance that your liver function will start to decline.
Okay. I know I shouldn't be happy, but I'm actually quite buoyed by the results because what they do mean is that I have a chance to change things. I'm not seriously unhealthy yet, but I could be.
Nairi is the lightest in the team, but surprisingly she has the second highest body percentage fat. Her bad cholesterol is just over the healthy level of 3, and luckily her good cholesterol is the highest in the group.
On average, the girls did not do too badly. I mean, their cholesterols were both high, but in terms of their good cholesterols, you know, both had fairly decent levels of good cholesterol, which is a protective thing. But their percentage body fats were a bit unexpected. Now, your percentage body fat for a woman, ideally should be between 18% and 26%.
Okay.
Now, your level came to 42%.
42, really? Oh my gosh. Well, right now I'm really just going, oh my gosh, my body fat percentage is very high. That's something I really want to work on. And it was
mostly drying. My body percentage fat is also high at 41%. According to my BMI, I'm in the obese category. My bad cholesterol is high at 3.8. However, I do have high levels of good cholesterol.
Yours is 41%.
Oh, okay. So I mean, half my body is fat.
Well, that is a fairly high rate.
Okay. I was expecting it to be high, but 41? Oh my gosh, that doesn't sound good.
John is the second heaviest in the team, weighing in at 133 kilograms. His BMI and body percentage fat are also high. John's liver tests were abnormal, which means he'll need an ultrasound. His kidney results show he's prone to gout, which will mean he'll have to stay away from some of his favourites, like seafood, tomatoes and beer.
John Utanga is morbidly obese according to his BMI. We're going to actually do an ultrasound of his liver as well because his liver function tests were quite markedly elevated, and which is a little bit higher than what I'd expect for his cholesterol level. The next measurement I have to do, John, is just above your pelvic bone as well. Okay.
The really fatty area.
The really big area, so that's above you.
The so-called tractor tire.
The good news is that you don't have diabetes.
Fantastic news.
Yeah,
I feel like I've got diabetes.
Ideally for a man, percentage body fat for you should be between 12% and 18%. Your level is 39.5%.
39%?
39.5%.
Holy cow.
Actually, let's round it up, 40%.
40%.
Tangalore Tele is the heaviest of the team, weighing in at 174 kilograms. His body percentage fat is almost 45%, and his BMI is over 40, putting him in the morbidly obese range. His good cholesterol is under the recommended 1.0, and his bad cholesterol is high and over the recommended 3.0. Only weeks before filming this, Tangalore Tele was hit with some grave news from his family doctor. It's more than likely that he's got type 2 diabetes.
The thing with Osone is that not only is his cholesterol level high, his percentage body fat's also very high. Add diabetes to that. Now that puts his cardiovascular risk right up there. You may need to go on medication.
Just to help bring it down?
To help bring it down.
Will that be like long term or just short term, the medication?
Once we put you on medication, it's long term.
Oh, are you serious? I'm pretty shocked, but it's good to hear a breakdown of where I'm actually at. Philosophically, I just think it's better to know than not know.
Your liver function tests tell me that you are actually now starting to form what we call a fatty layer around your liver. Now, your percentage body fat, though, remember the calibers that we were using on the day?
The ones that wouldn't fit around the side.
Do you want me to tell you what yours was? 44.7%.
Okay, that's no surprise, really. Okay. That's almost half my body's fat. I always knew it was going to be high, but it's given me a good base figure to work from and see where I can get down from there. Don't know that I can make it between the 12 to 18. It sounds like a super athlete to me, but hey, I'll give it my best shot.
So all up, our team results aren't flash. Every single member has high LDL or bad cholesterol.
They lead such busy, busy lives. They tend to grab food on the go all the time. And so it sounds to me that a lot of them have takeaways more often than not. If they don't make the changes now, there's a higher chance of them getting into trouble. Maybe not in the next few months, but certainly in the next few years.
Next time on Walk the Talk.
No words. No words, there's no guessing thing.
I feel like spearing up.
I totally know what Marama's talking about, but I know it's time for all of us to follow suit.
I look forward to seeing their progress and your progress too.
Oh, thanks.